Hello, my beautiful YouTube and internet friends. My channel is all about showing you how you can do your art journaling, mixed media and crafting on a low budget. My name is Ilona, better known on YouTube, Facebook, Instagram and WordPress as Picture for Life. Every Thursday you will find new and free easy tutorial videos for art journaling and mixed media. Subscribe to my channel to follow me on my creative journey. I'm all about keeping it simple. Even if it looks difficult, it's not. Trust me. I make easy to follow process tutorial videos for art journaling and mixed media. So if you like to see more low budget, mixed media and art journaling, subscribe to my YouTube channel and click the bell icon so you know when I upload a new video. You can also follow me on Facebook, Instagram and I have a blog on WordPress. So join me for a new, fun and low-budget mixed-media project. Do you need a lot of materials for art journaling? No, you do not. With just some basic materials like paints, pens, markers, stamps, you can get started. On my blog there is a post about doing your art journaling and mixed-media low-budget. And I will link that post in the description below this video. The page I'm working on is not prepped with gesso and it's just a normal journal. It has no mixed media papers in it and I still can just make a beautiful page. Today I am playing in my experimental journal. I'm testing out some colors. I'm mixing a purple and a pearl metallic paint together and adding a lot of water and splattering with that just to see how they react. And I really added a lot of water, so I need to dry my pages very well. There's no plan for this page yet, so I start adding some layers. First I do some stamping and then I am using the purple paint without diluting it. I take a stencil and a sponge and add my paint through the stencil, just randomly on a few places. Till it looks like I have some balance. With the leftover paint I add some marks with my fan brush randomly to the page before I decide it needs something black for a bit of balance to the page. First I add some black paint through a stencil. I have this stencil and I have no clue who it's from. It's a very old one, but it has this really tiny design on it that gives just something extra. If you do not have any stencils, it's really easy to make them yourself. The easiest way is to use some punches. And after that I think it still needs more balance. So I use the black paint up and add it onto a circle stamp and stamp that a few times on the page. So now my background is done. I'm starting to think about a focal point for my page and also about a theme. For my focal point I decide to use a very old stamp by Craft Sensations and I stamp that with Versamic ink and add Ranger Perfect Pearls in a bronze color. It's a pretty old product. But it has all these shimmers in it and it's really, really beautiful. First I stamp it on cardstock and cut it out. And when I lay it on my page, I think, no, I don't want it to have to lay on top of my page. I really like it when it's more integrated in the page, more part of the page than just something that I glue on top of it. And that's when I decide to stamp it again, but then on some kind of baking paper. It's something I bought a long time ago and just used it actually to separate my pages when I work on the pages and use a lot of water. It, of course, the water goes through my page and I do not want it to get on the other page underneath. So I had this actually to put between my pages. But then I once found out that if I stamped on it, it kind of reacted just like the collage papers from Tim Holtz. So it kind of almost disappears into my background. And that's what I want here. I want my image to be integrated in the page. So I stamp it again onto this paper. And then on the inside, I use a stamp of a dancing lady. And this stamp belongs to the same stamp set as my Baroque oval frame. So it fits perfectly inside. I also want to add a crown on top of my frame, because one side has some kind of an ornament on, but the other side is just pretty plain. And I also stamped my dancing lady upside down. So now the top of my frame is actually the bottom side, which has no decoration on it, and it just doesn't feel right. So what I do is I find a little stamp of a crown and stamp that on the same paper again with the Versamark ink, and also adding the perfect pearls to it. And the idea is to merge them together if I glue them onto my page. So I have an ornament on the top of my Baroque frame. And I use a kind of a Mod Podge to glue them on my page. And after I dried it with my heat tool, I picked up some cheap glitter gel pens and started to add some color and a little sparkle to my image. Now you really have to dry your Mod Podge very well before you do this step, because otherwise your pens are ruined. With the same purple gel pen, I also add in some color in parts of the black circles. They are not really solid blacks. It's kind of more of a distressed stamp. So there are still some places that I can put some color in, which I do with the purple gel pen. It's a very subtle layer, and you probably won't see it on the video very well, but it's there. And now it's time for a title onto my page. And again, I used the same kind of see-through paper, which is actually kind of a cheap substitute for the Tim Holtz collage paper. At least I use it for that. Out of my stash, I digged up some really old funky leather stamps, and I stamped out the phrase "free to dance." The theme I wanted to go for is freedom, and I collaged that onto my page. And here is where my page ended up a few weeks ago. And when I returned to it recently, I thought it needed some bronze gold to balance out the frame. And I had a few options, like golden flakes, but I decided on doing some stenciling. And now I wish I did the flakes, which is much more time consuming. I actually do not like the border that I stenciled on. I think it's too overpowering. But hey, what's done is done. And to stencil this border on, I just had a piece of, I think I got it from a gift wrap, and I used it as a stencil to stencil it through. And in a little try for a rescue mission, I added a scribbled border in black, but sadly that does not do the trick. But hey, in the end, sometimes just your end result is not that satisfying. If I do not like something about my page, I mostly keep trying to add, or sometimes I do the gesso over it. But in this case, I just left it. Even though the end result was not quite satisfying to me, sometimes you just had fun playing. So I hope you do like my page, and let me know how you feel about the border, if you think it was better without it, or if you maybe do like it. Thank you so much for watching, and have a wonderful and creative day. And I hope to see you back next week for a new free tutorial video. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell icon so you will be notified when my new video is up. Bye bye!